Philippine shares failed to sustain their four-day rally. The main index now back below the 7,100 level after shedding over 1% or some 80 points. Value turnover was slightly higher at 6 billion pesos. Regina Capital Development Corporation says Philippine shares succumbed to profit-taking. In company news, the Bank of the Philippine Islands, or BPI, reports its net income for the first quarter of the year reaching 8 billion pesos. That's nearly 60% higher year-on-year. Now, its total revenues also rose over 4%. BPI shares ended higher following the news. We're now joined by Angelo Calabio of the Philippine Business Bank. Good afternoon, Angelo, and welcome to Market Edge.
Good afternoon, Stanley. Pleasure having you.
It's good to have you here. Now, PSEI finally corrected following days of green. The index finishing as 7061, down 1.13% from Wednesday, when it digested better IMF growth outlook for the Philippines. Now, the excitement did not seem to rub off today. It wasn't carried over. Why is that?
Well, it's really that the market seesaw in the morning between gains and losses. And as we saw very clearly, investors' top slice as the PSEI, the index, hit the resistance level of about 7,100. I believe personally that the resistance is actually at about the 7.2 level, but right now support seems that it will hold very strongly at about the 7,000 level. So we will see it a little trading to be a bit range bound at least for the rest of the week.
Okay, and on the subject of support and resistance, thin trades accompanying previous days' rally signaling these might not be sustainable. As you've mentioned earlier, what support level are we hoping not to breach? And is there a chance of breaking resistance of 7,200? And what might make that possible?
Well, right now, Stanley, it's really about, I think everyone is in the wait and see mode about the monetary policy, especially given that the Fed has indicated, the US Fed has indicated that they will accelerate tightening to at least about 50 bips in the next six Fed FOMC meetings. So we do expect that the BSP will eventually follow the trend, and that could be a near-term catalyst. But on the short term, the election, the excitement about the elections, of course, historically, we see a rally before and a little after the elections. So if we do breach the 7,200 level, we see a run up to about the 7.4 to 7.5 levels easily.
And looking at some bright spots, travel has almost returned to normal with airlines and hotels reporting higher than expected income from Holy Week alone. Now, have you revised your outlook for issues like Philippine Airlines perhaps or Cebu Pacific, given passenger load factor increasing, even if fuel prices remain a concern?
Well, there's some value to be had there, honestly. But right now we're still in a wait and see mode because it's a delicate balance between the increased passenger traffic and still weighing heavily on the airlines is really the fuel cost. No, right. We see another increase in the world markets this week, and we do expect another fuel price increase next week for us consumers. So that still a little bit dampens the optimism in terms of the airline industry so far.
And still on some corporate stories, Bank of the Philippine Islands income for the first quarter of the year 2022 up almost 60% on account of higher interest income and of course lower provisions. Now, are better earnings and lower bad loan provisions a trend for most banks in a recovering economy?
We do expect that to be the trend, at least for the first half of the year. We expect the lending activities to really accelerate as businesses recover and as we go back to pre-pandemic capacities and levels. But one thing that the banks will need to really be looking after would be the margins, given that we do expect a upside increase in yields. So that's something to look out for, especially for the banking names that we follow.
All right. Angelo Calabio, Philippine Business Bank, thank you for your market guidance.